Nutrition Week celebrated from 1 September to 7 September. Due to this pandemic situation, we have chosen online platform to celebrate our National Nutrition Week. And my student have prepared something special from this week. So let's start and thank you.
Hello everyone.
I am second year student of food and nutrition. In this video, we discuss about osteoporosis and osteomalacia. All vital process in human life like working, walking, jumping and enjoy with good life apply healthy bones. The normal bone formation required some significant amount of minerals like calcium and phosphorus. Also vitamin D, which plays an important role in the movement of calcium into bone, which is responsible for healthy bones. The insufficient amount of these minerals are responsible for osteoporosis and osteomalacia.
Osteoporosis is a condition that affects the bones. The inside of a healthy bone has small spaces. Osteoporosis increases the size of these spaces, causing the bone to lose strength and density.
It can occur in people of any age, but it more common in older adults, especially in women.
Osteomalacia is a weakening of bones. Problems with bone formation or the bone building process causes osteomalacia.
This condition isn't same as osteoporosis. Osteomalacia happens in the areas where muscle attaches to bone. A person with osteomalacia may have a hard time walking.
In addition to your treatment plan, an appropriate diet can help strengthen your bones. To keep your bones healthy, you need to include certain nutrients in your diet. The most important ones are calcium and vitamin D. Your body needs calcium to maintain strong bones and it needs vitamin D to absorb calcium.
Calcium-rich foods like milk, cheese, spinach, lettuce finger, drumstick leaves, etc.
Vitamin D-rich foods like milk, cheese, butter, egg yolk, cabbage, fatty fishes like salmon, tuna, mackerel, etc.
Other nutrients that promote bone health include zinc, magnesium, potassium, and vitamin K.
Zinc-rich foods like peanuts, whole grains, breakfast cereals, dairy products, etc.
Magnesium-rich foods like pumpkin seeds, spinach, almonds, peanuts, etc.
Potassium-rich foods like bananas, spinach, potato, cucumber, broccoli, dry fruits, etc.
Vitamin K-rich foods like spinach, broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, egg, meat, fish, cereals, etc.
Once you began treatment for the condition, any cracks in your bones will heal normally.
Though you may need painkillers in the meantime, you should avoid intensive exercise until the cracks have healed.
I hope this information will help you. Thank you.
Hello everybody, I am third semester student of Food and Nutrition Department. Today, I will present a short lecture on this topic, food adulteration. So, the topic is about food is the basic necessity of life. It is essential for health and life, but this food must be clean, pure and fresh. Nowadays, foods are often adulterated.
Do you know what is food adulteration? Adulteration is defined as the process by which the quality of the foodstuff is reduced by the addition of a foreign substance or by the removal of any of its nutrient component. Example: milk is adulterated by the addition of water or by the removal of butter from it. Next, modes of adulteration of foods. They are additional of foreign substances, removal of quality ingredients from the food item, preparation of food under unhygienic conditions, obtained food from a diseased animal, incorporation of poisonous component, entering of harmful constituent from the container used, use of non-permitted additives, food adulterants and their harmful effect. In India, almost all foods are adulterated. Adulteration lowers the nutritive value of food. Some common adulteration and many foods I will discuss one by one. Number 1. Milk adulterants are unhygienic water, chalk powder, soap powder, starch, hydrogen peroxide and urea. Harmful effect. Food poisonous, heart problem, cancer, vomiting, nausea. T. Adulterants, colored and processed used tea leaves. Harmful effect, liver disorder. Chili powder. Adulterants, brick powder, sawdust. Harmful effect, stomach problem and artificial color can cause cancer. Turmeric powder. Adulterants, yellow aniline dye and non-permitted colorants like methanol yellow. Harmful effect, carcinogen. Ghee. Adulterants, vegetable oil, animal body fats. Harmful effect, anemia and enlargement of heart. Coffee powder. Adulterants, tamarind powder and chicory powder. Harmful effect, diarrhea, stomach disorder, giddiness, joint pain. Sugar. Adulterants, chalk powder. Harmful effect, stomach disorder.
I hope you understand the harmful effect present in the food item. Thank you.
আমি সুস্মিতা রাজবংশী, নিউট্রিশন থার্ড সেমিস্টারের স্টুডেন্ট। আজকে থাইরয়েড ডিজিজ নিয়ে কিছু আলোচনা করব। বর্তমানে থাইরয়েড ডিজিজটি খুবই কমন একটি রোগে পরিণত হয়েছে। বর্তমান ভারতের পপুলেশনের প্রায় 42 মিলিয়ন পপুলেশন এই রোগটি দ্বারা আক্রান্ত। আমরা আমাদের ডায়েটে কিছু কিছু খাদ্য ইনক্লুড করে এই রোগটি হওয়া থেকে প্রিভেন্ট করতে পারি নিজেকে। তো চলুন দেখে নেই যে থাইরয়েড রোগটি ক প্রকারের হয়। থাইরয়েড মূলত দু প্রকারের হয়। হাইপোথাইরয়েডিজম এবং হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম। হাইপোথাইরয়েডিজম যখন আমাদের বডিতে প্রয়োজনের তুলনায় কম পরিমাণে থাইরয়েড হরমোন উৎপন্ন হয় এবং হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম যখন আমাদের বডিতে প্রয়োজনের তুলনায় বেশি পরিমাণে হরমোন উৎপন্ন হয়। আমরা কিছু কিছু খাবার যুক্ত করে নিজেদের খাদ্য তালিকায় যুক্ত করে এই হাইপোথাইরয়েডিজম হওয়া থেকে নিজেকে প্রিভেন্ট করতে পারি। নাম্বার 1, আয়োডিন যুক্ত লবণ। আমরা যে কোনো নর্মাল লবণকে আয়োডিনযুক্ত লবণের সাথে রিপ্লেস করে রান্নায় ব্যবহার করতে পারি। 2 নম্বর, যে কোনো রকমের মাছ। মাছে থাকে ওমেগা 3 ফ্যাটি অ্যাসিড। নাম্বার 3, ডিম। ডিমে রয়েছে প্রচুর পরিমাণে আয়োডিন। এর জন্য আমাদের খাদ্য তালিকায় ডিম রাখা খুবই জরুরি। নাম্বার 4, শিম জাতীয় পদার্থ। বিভিন্ন শিম জাতীয় পদার্থ যেমন ছোলা, ডাল, বিনস, রাজমা, এ সমস্ত খাবার আমাদের খাদ্য তালিকায় রাখা উচিত, কারণ এ সমস্ত খাদ্যে রয়েছে প্রচুর পরিমাণে আয়োডিন, যা আমাদের এই রোগের সঙ্গে লড়তে সাহায্য করে। নাম্বার 5, দুগ্ধ জাতীয় পদার্থ। দুগ্ধ জাতীয় পদার্থ যেমন দুধ, পনির এবং দই, এ সমস্ত পদার্থে থাকে প্রচুর পরিমাণে আয়োডিন। এই আয়োডিন আমাদের থাইরয়েড হরমোনকে নিয়ন্ত্রণ করতে সাহায্য করে। নাম্বার 6, অলিভ অয়েল। আমরা এই হাইপোথাইরয়েডিজমের ক্ষেত্রে অলিভ অয়েল দিয়ে রান্না করব। এই অলিভ অয়েলে থাকে পুষ্টিকর ফ্যাট, যা আমাদের স্বাস্থ্যের পক্ষে খুবই ভালো। নাম্বার 7, বিভিন্ন শাকসবজি। শাকসবজিতে থাকে প্রচুর পরিমাণে ভিটামিন, মিনারেলস, ফাইবার এবং অ্যান্টিঅক্সিডেন্ট। কিন্তু আমরা এই সময় কিছু কিছু শাকসবজিকে অ্যাভয়েড করব, কারণ এই শাকসবজিগুলো আমাদের থাইরয়েড হরমোন ক্ষরণ করাকে বাধা দেয়। যেমন বাঁধাকপি, ফুলকপি, ব্রকলি, পালং শাক এবং ফলের মধ্যে গাজর, টমেটো, জাম, কিউই এ সমস্ত। নাম্বার 8, মাংস। মাংসে থাকে বিভিন্ন প্রকারের প্রোটিন, যা আমাদের স্বাস্থ্যের পক্ষে খুবই ভালো। হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম, এবার আমরা জেনে নিব হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম এর ক্ষেত্রে কি কি খাওয়া উচিত। প্রথম নাম্বার 1, গ্রিন টি। গ্রিন টিতে রয়েছে অ্যান্টিথাইরয়েড যুক্ত উপাদান, যা আমাদের থাইরয়েড হরমোন কে ক্ষরণ হতে বাধা দেয়। অর্থাৎ আমরা প্রতিদিন 1 কাপ করে গ্রিন টি খেলে তা আমাদের স্বাস্থ্যের পক্ষে ভালো। দ্বিতীয়ত, প্রচুর পরিমাণে শাকসবজি। এই সময় আমরা বাঁধাকপি, ফুলকপি, ব্রকলি, পালং শাক এ সমস্ত শাকসবজি এবং ফলের মধ্যে কমলা লেবু, কিউই, জাম এ সমস্ত বেশি করে পরিমাণে খাবো, কারণ এই সমস্ত এই শাকসবজিগুলো আমাদের থাইরয়েড হরমোনের। নাম্বার 3, ব্রাউন রাইস। ব্রাউন রাইসে রয়েছে প্রচুর পরিমাণে ভিটামিন, মিনারেলস এবং ফাইবার। আমাদের প্রতিদিন 1/2 কাপ থেকে 1 কাপ ব্রাউন রাইস খাওয়ার অভ্যাস করা উচিত। নাম্বার 4, প্রোটিন জাতীয় পদার্থ। প্রোটিন জাতীয় পদার্থ যেমন মাছ, মাংস, ডিম, সয়াবিন, মাশরুম, বিভিন্ন দুগ্ধ পদার্থ আমাদের এ সময় খাওয়া খুবই প্রয়োজনীয়, কারণ এ সমস্ত প্রোটিন জাতীয় পদার্থ আমাদের স্বাস্থ্যের পক্ষে খুবই উপকারী। এবং যেহেতু হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজমের একটি বিশেষ সমস্যা হলো বারবার খিদে পেয়ে যাওয়া, যেহেতু প্রোটিনগুলো হজম হতে বেশি সময় লাগে, তাই এই সমস্যাটি কিছুটা হলেও দূর হতে পারে। তাহলে এগুলি ছিল কিছু খাবার যা আমরা হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজম এবং হাইপারথাইরয়েডিজমের ক্ষেত্রে নিজের ডায়েটে ইনক্লুড করে সুস্থ থাকতে পারি।
Hello, today I here to talk about which types of foods are required during pregnancy to maintain a healthy diet. Pregnancy is one of the most effective time to attempt nutrition education. It is one of the most happiest phases in a woman's life. But stress, anxiety, fatigue and many other psychosocial characteristics may also influence the food choice of a pregnant woman. So, it is the best time when mother is willing to practice for a principle balanced diet, as it helps both the mother and the baby. The normal energy requirement of an adult woman is about 1900 calories per day. During pregnancy, the nutritional requirement is increased to improve baby's health. In fact, need to add extra 300 to 400 calories per day during second and third trimester. Okay, let's see some superfoods which are important for a pregnant woman.
Number 1, dairy products. During pregnancy, the consumption of dairy products is very important. It helps meet the extra requirement of calcium and proteins, which gives support to growing fetus. Drink at least 1 glass of milk a day and consume more ghee, yogurt, paneer to keep baby healthy.
Number 2, eggs. Eggs are considered as superfoods by many as they are a great source of vitamins, proteins and minerals. The proteins present in eggs makes them good for the growing baby, which is essential for the development of the brain and nervous system of unborn baby.
Number 3, sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes are a very good source of beta carotene, which is converted into vitamin A inside the baby, and it is essential for the growth of cells. Vitamin A also helps in boosting the immunity and improving the vision.
Number 4,
Number 4. Legumes. Legumes are the group of foods which includes lentils, soybeans, peas and beans. They are an excellent source of plant-based fiber, protein, calcium and iron. And all of these are very important for a pregnant woman. Number 5. Nuts. Nuts are delicious and they are full of healthy fats. They have brain-boosting omega-3 fatty acid, proteins, fibers, and other essential nutrients which are important for the development of the baby. Number 6. Orange juice. Orange juice can fill up with potassium and vitamin C. It can provide with necessary nutrients which will prevent various types of birth defects. So have one glass of orange juice every day as a part of breakfast. Number 7. Green leafy vegetables. Leafy vegetables are rich in nutrients and it can help protecting the body against a lot of disease. Bring a rich source of antioxidant, proteins, fiber, calcium, vitamins and potassium are a great addition for pregnancy diet. Number 8. Bananas. Bananas are a great source of folic acid, calcium, potassium and vitamin B6. They are also rich in antioxidant and they help in boosting the energy. Number 9. Oatmeal. Oatmeal has various type of health benefits. The intake of carbohydrate is necessary for all of us, especially pregnant women. Oatmeal is a good source of selenium, vitamin B, phosphorus and calcium. So, have it for breakfast during pregnancy phase. Number 10. Salmon. Salmon is rich in omega-3 fatty acid, which is very good for heart health. Salmon is also a great source of vitamin D, which is important for the brain health as well as immunity. We hope these informations will help you and have a good life to you and your baby.
Well, I am third semester student of nutrition. Today I talk to you about immunity boosting vitamins. The most important vitamin that helps to boost immunity and why is it so important to our body. The vitamin that we are going to talk about is none other than vitamin C. We look at why vitamin C is so effective of in boosting immunity. We will also see which are the best food that we should take get good amount of vitamin C. And then we will answer the question why there we should take vitamin C supplement or not.
Vitamin C is also called ascorbic acid. Is an essential micronutrient in for humans. It is a potent antioxidant and acts as a cofactor for various enzymes. Vitamin C is with a reputation as an immune system booster as an antioxidant. Vitamin C fights free radicals in the body and which helps to prevent many cancers and heart disease and promotes healthy aging. How does vitamin C boost immunity? Vitamin C affects our immunity in multiple ways. The immune system can generate reactive oxygen species, especially during times of infections. ROS are basically chemicals that our own WBC produce to kill the microorganisms. These chemicals that also lead to a significant amount of damage to our own cells. Since vitamin C is an antioxidant, it can help to neutralize the oxidative damage caused by this ROS to these immune cells, resulting in an improved and immune function. Primary function of vitamin C is to neutralize the oxidative damage, promoting hypochlorous acid generated by activity of neutrophils. Vitamin C deficiency results in impaired immunity and higher sensibility to infections.
How much vitamin C do you need every day? Vitamin C is a water-soluble vitamin. It cannot be stored inside your body. So you need to take a daily dose of vitamin C to maintain an optimal concentration of our body. According to the National Academy of Science in US, we should have intake of 75 to 90 mg per day. Source of vitamin C. Vitamin C occurred widely in plant food, particularly in fresh fruit and vegetable, especially green leafy vegetable. Food of animal organ do not contain vitamin C. Amla is the richest source of vitamin C. And other source of vitamin C are guava, cabbage, orange, reddish leaf, papaya, capsicum, etc. Substantial number of Americans have low intake levels of vitamin C due to the inadequate intake of fruits and vegetables. Requirement of vitamin C is our body is increased during periods of infections, flu and common cold. Supplement. Regularly getting 500 to 1000 mg vitamin C per day reduce during of common cold symptoms and boost your immune system. We can also help prevent iron deficiency anemia. So such high amount of vitamin C difficult to get a natural source. So I suggest supplementing with 500 to 1000 mg of vitamin C per day. I recommended Nutralite vitamin C extend release tablet that contain 500 mg of vitamin C in every.
I am a food and nutrition student of first year. Today I am going to talk about anemia. Anemia is the most common blood related disorder which occurs mainly by the abnormally low levels of red blood cell. It is not only a single disease but a group of disorder in which hemoglobin concentration is below the normal range for the age and sex of the subject. Iron deficiency anemia is the most common form of anemia. It is common in both male and female. But girls are the most victim of anemia due to some other reasons. Apart from that, the children also suffered from anemia. Iron deficiency anemia is a major public health problem. In both rural and urban areas, it can be seen that girls have been suffering from anemia. Cause. 92% reason of anemia is for the deficiency of iron. There are various causes of anemia and first and foremost cause is
inadequate dietary intake of iron. Maximum young girls and children does not like to include the iron-rich food such as jaggery, green leafy vegetables and other iron-rich food in their diet. Or poor family cannot manage nutrient food for their economic status. Secondly, blood loss in different condition including injury, bleeding piles or secretion too much blood at the time of menstrual cycle can lead to anemia. And thirdly, the physiological condition where iron demand are increased, like for example in pregnancy and in lactation and also infancy, childhood and adolescence. If fail to match up those requirements, then the condition lead to anemia. And last, decreased absorption of iron. For the deficiency of vitamin C, iron absorption is inhibited. So, for the less intake of vitamin C, anemia reach awkward. Symptoms. If you have your hemoglobin level less than 13.5 and if you are a male, then you are known to anemia. And in case of women, if your hemoglobin concentration fall below 12%, then it is anemia. Anemia can lead to variety of symptoms like weakness, lack of concentration, tiredness and dizziness, etc. Requirement. On an average, an adult should consume approx 7 to 20 mg of iron every day. Therefore, only 10% iron of the total dietary intake is absorbed in our body. Prevention. Proper diet can definitely prevent anemia. Hemoglobin can be increased through two sources. One is heme iron and one is non-heme iron. When talk about heme sources, these are the sources found in animal like fish, egg, chicken, mutton. Liver is an excellent source of iron. Prawn and crab muscle are also great source of iron. When talk about non-heme sources, those are found in plants like broccoli, mustard leaves, whole grain food, nuts, pulses, and green leafy vegetables. All these are non-heme source of iron. Dates are the rich source of iron. Not just eating, but right combination help improving hemoglobin. To increase iron levels, need to combine with vitamin C rich foods like amla, guava, salad, and seasonal fruits. So if you consume this iron rich food, definitely iron can grow up. Incorporating green leafy vegetable like cauliflower, greens, seasonal vegetables and fruit in the diet of the infant and preschool children. But the consumption of tea or coffee along with meals greatly reduce the absorption of non-heme iron. We hope this information will help you and give some relief in this panic.